So if you ever wanted to be a great bullshit artist, you learn from the masters. Learn from the masters. Study the masters, even in music. If you want to learn how to play great guitar, you watch great guitarists. If you want to be a master bullshit artist, master, I mean the greatest bullshit artist ever, watch these two characters, right? So there's a trigger alert. Trigger alert. If you can't stand, if it's going to cost you throwing your screen out the window, watching Hillary Clinton lie, then brace yourself. You know, maybe you don't want to watch it. So there is a you know, don't throw your screen out the window. So here's Hillary Clinton, right? So this guy Trevor Noah, the late night talk show guy, asks Hillary Clinton, how did you kill Jeffrey Epstein? How did you kill Jeffrey Epstein? Watch this. It's fascinating.
Hillary, I have to ask you a question that has been plaguing me for a while. How did you kill Jeffrey Epstein? Because you're not in power, but you have all the power. I really need to understand how you do what you do. Because you seem to be behind everything nefarious, and yet you do not use it to become president. What is the game plan?
Well, Trevor.
But honestly, though, what does it feel like being the boogeyman of the right?
Well, it's a constant surprise to me. Because the things they say, and now, of course, it's on steroids with being online, are so ridiculous beyond any imagination that I could have. And yet they are so persistent in putting forth these crazy ideas and theories. Honestly, I don't know what I ever did to get them so upset.
Well, let's remind you, maybe you lied about coming down and under Bosnian sniper fire. You had two FBI investigations during your presidential run for destroying evidence. You lied to Congress 7 times. You probably killed 50 people. Seth Rich, come on. You cheated Bernie Sanders. We caught you with WikiLeaks. It's disgusting. Disgusting. Can't own it, right? Master bullshit artist. Is she believable? Of course not. But Trevor, whatever his name is, believes it, I guess.
But a lot of them live to come up with these conspiracy theories. And, you know, I've gotten kind of used to it. It's been going on for a number of years.
Have you ever thought of just, like, meeting someone who says, like, Hillary, you did this, and just looking at them and being like, yes, I did. I mean, there must be...
At some point.
Right, at some point.
At some point.
It becomes so ludicrous and it becomes so extreme.
Well, I've had encounters like that, and many of my friends have had, because they...
Wow.
Yeah, they've called up people to urge them to, like, vote for me, or they've knocked on a door, and somebody will say, oh, I couldn't do that, because... And then they launch into one of their big conspiracies. And I had one very dear friend, who I literally have known my entire life. And she said she listened to this ridiculous conspiracy about me. And she said, you know, I've known her since we were in sixth grade, and none of that is true. And this man looked at her and said, but I saw it on the internet.
But I also think it's because it is effective. Like, I'll never forget reading an article after the 2016 election where the reporter interviewed someone who had been an undecided voter, and he said, you know, he thought my mom had won all 3 debates. She clearly had a greater command of the subject matter. And yet he just kept reading that she had murdered more than 50 people. And he said somewhat
That's a low estimate.
Nonchalantly, like, I don't think that she murdered 50, but, like, what if she murdered 2? And so you just think it's this, like, constant erosion of truth and sanity.
Right.
But my favorite, and the one that I do secretly hope maybe...
She didn't do it with her own 2 hands. She does it through proxies.
True is that my mother apparently adopted an alien in 1993, and I've always wanted a sibling. So I hope maybe that one will prove out at some point.
But you know, Trevor, you have to laugh at it because it's so crazy. But on the other hand, we face a serious problem of a lot of these falsehoods and these crazy stories taking on lives of their own, not about me, but about everybody,
right,
and particularly anybody in the public arena. And I have been very outspoken about the decision by Facebook to allow truly false political ads to be run. I want to applaud Twitter for announcing they were.
All right. The greatest liar. She just lied about. She just lied about Jill Stein and Tulsi Gabbard, calling them Russian agents. So, now that you saw a little Hillary Clinton lying, did she kill Jeffrey Epstein? Did she sneak in into the cell and do it with her own two hands? No, but can you link? Can you follow those trails? Are we jumping the conclusion to say that Hillary Clinton is deeply corrupt and may have been involved in the murder of Jeffrey Epstein? No, it's not unrealistic. Power flows downstream, and Hillary Clinton's still disgusting as ever. I feel like I gotta go take a shower now, man. It's just like, just seeing a lie like that, you know, minimizing. She's on late night television minimizing her vile behavior, her vile past, her vile lying, her cheating, the way she lives her life, right? It's just disgusting, you know what I mean? It's probably one of the most hated politicians in American history. Not just because we feel like hating her, because she's earned it. She has earned the reputation as master bullshit artist. Okay, short video. Marcus Conte reporting.